Yeah.
Music Disney Fantasia, what's it called?
Music of Fantasia, Disney's Fantasia Music Evolved, I think.
Beautiful. Okay, so this kind of crept up. I think it came out either 1 week or 2 weeks ago. I've been keeping an eye on it the whole time because it's a harmonics game, and I felt terrible for harmonics when Microsoft decided to discontinue the Kinect as a bundle in because they've been working on this thing for years, and you could just imagine how crestfallen they were when they're like, oh. Because it's a weird game. It's a weird game. Like, what's the best way to describe it? At a fundamental point, it's a game about basically being a conductor. It's a rhythm action game, obviously, and the kind of interactions that you're asked to do are stuff that you could probably imagine at a basic level. Swiping your hands, punching forwards. There's little things where you sort of have to punch and then move slowly, matching a little sparkly thing on screen. It's stuff that is kind of been, it's kind of similar to other things that have existed. It's actually very similar, I think, to what's that called? A Windan on the DS, but obviously without a stick. But you know, you have to have your hand in the right place and stuff. It works surprisingly well. I barely had any issues with the technology at all, and I'd say only some because I was assigned to sit on a slightly weird chair and it was losing my hand a little bit. I think if you stood up, you'd have no problem at all. But what's really fascinating about this game is that after the first few levels where it's teaching you the very basics, you unlock the ability to start remixing the tracks, and that's basically what the game's all about. Right, how best to describe this? So, say you've got a track like Message in a Bottle by The Police. That's the one you play twice quite early on. The first time you play it, normal tune, play along, it's quite good fun. Good song. Second time, you unlock the ability to remix it. Now, every track in the game has two remixes and the original, but at this point, you only have one remix, which is this weird kind of almost orchestral remix of the song. So at certain points in the song, you will get the ability to it will sort of divide the song. What's the best way to describe it? You'll get the ability to choose the remix or to choose one of the instruments from the original.
Yeah, midway through the song. I mean, I think you have to get to 7,500. It's a certain score. Once you reach that certain score, you pull off a certain move and you can decide either to go with one element of the song from the remix or the original.
So essentially, you can then build your own versions of the songs because it's not like you're playing the original and then you're playing the entire remix. It's more that one of the instruments will drop out of the original and you've got the choice to bring it back in or pick one of the instruments from the remix. So you can either just completely play the remix version or just start bringing other elements of the original back in, or later on you'll get the third version as well. So you can, I mean, it's mind-blowingly brilliant, frankly. And just further proof, if any were needed, which nothing is needed in this respect, really, that harmonics are geniuses. I mean, this game should be talked about a lot because I created this fucking weird version of The Police's Message in a Bottle with my hands in my room. And it was really good. And then I brought the guitars back in at the end and then changed the drums. And it's scripted to a point. You can only do so much, and the game chooses which instruments you bring in and out. But you are creating versions of songs, and then later on it gives you the ability to be able to actually put your own loops in tracks at certain points, which you can do by kind of drawing your hand across the screen and you can hear them playing through the track. It's really quite something. It really is. It functions in some ways similar to the remix mode in Frequency, but it's more structured than that. I don't know if people remember that, and it's quite old now, but Palmorix have obviously had this stuff in their pocket for a while. The only problems I have with the game is all the stuff in between the songs. It's Fantasia, so it's kind of based on this. Is it the Sorcerer's Apprentice part of the Fantasia movie?
It's very tenuous.
But it's very tenuous, but it makes you do. There's cutscenes of the boring wizard, and then there's bits where you have to kind of explore these environments and move around your room and find songs in the environment. Basically, I just don't want to do any of that. I just want to play the songs. All that stuff's bollocks. You can, like, stroke some seahorses and they dance. I don't care. Maybe kids will care, but kids, it's way too hard for kids to play.
You think?
The songs start to ramp up quite quickly, I think.
Yeah, they do get more taxing, but I don't know. I mean, when you're a
kid... There's no fail state, I guess. So.
Exactly, exactly. I mean, some of those little mini games, like the jazz clams, when you're sort of making a little drum loop on the jazz clams and then you can save it, I thought that was really cool. So, there are some... some of it's really intuitive to make a little beat and then record it. Like the sound sketcher, when you just make melodies and then record them. I mean, it's really cool stuff, but... Yeah, it is a game for kids. And I'm kind of disappointed that stuff that's in between the songs is all well and good and it's quite enjoyable, but it is for children. And at the end of the day, I wanted to be able to go to the main menu and just pick from the songs, but you can't. You have to unlock them. And I thought that that was a mistake that Harmonix had learned from, because the Rock Band game stopped doing that because they obviously were aware of how annoying it was that there's content on the disc that you can't get to. There's some really interesting tracks on the disc here, and I'm like, I want to play that. I want to play that song, but I can't. You have to go back and you have to go and search these environments. I mean, it's cool, but... And this is a game for children, but... I defy anyone not to be entertained by it. When I first played Bohemian Rhapsody, I just thought this is as enjoyable as playing Guitar Hero for the first time, and it worked so perfectly.
It was mustard.
Yes, so good, and it works beautifully. I mean, Kinect is a I think people have that technology is better than a lot of people give it credit for.
The Xbox One is definitely you can pick up your fingers and things like that.
Yeah, I mean, I think this is a really, really impressive package, but yeah, the primary disappointment is that you can't just play the content on the disc. You have to go and play these sort of interludes. And I'm going to do that because the game is definitely fun and definitely unique enough. It's pretty fantastic. I mean, I'm going to keep playing it. It's really good. I don't know what else to say. The co-op mode's really entertaining. As soon as you shake hands with somebody, it recognises there's someone else there and you play two players. It's really cool.
It's brilliant.
The production values are not great. I don't think there's probably going to be much of a difference between the 360 version and the Xbox One version, although obviously the new Kinect is far superior to the last one. It just works. It's as sort of invigorating and exciting as playing one of those band games for the first time.
Yeah, I was fully going full conductor mode as well. I used to play an orchestra when I was a kid, and I remember how weird that conductor was. He used to really get into it with a bunch of like 8-year-olds. And yeah, I was fully going for it, especially Bohemian Rhapsody. I mean, it goes without saying that song is quite incredible, but I had an even further appreciation for it just listening to it. Which is always a great thing about Harmonix games, you just hear music in a different way. And like making an undersea version of Mozart.
That's right. Yeah, it started sounding with all like
like the calypso drums and shit.
Yeah, brilliantly weird, kind of like samba music. I was like, it's so weird.
Yeah.
And what was the other one I did? Really, that's right. The message in a bottle. Really moody strings.
Yeah, and the like those heavy. I don't know what you call them. Those big drums that you hit with the sticks. Like boom, ba, boom, boom. You know. Yeah. So I had that in the background with the rest of it going, and then. It's just genius.
I made a drum and bass version of that Lord song.
That was the last track that I was doing. The Lord song.
I don't know if you'd say musically that those songs are ever improved by the remixes, but that's not really a complaint, because they are just brilliantly weird sometimes.
And sometimes it's funny and sometimes, but it's just kind of playing around with music. They're an amazing team.
I haven't really heard anything about this, so I don't know whether it's
reviewed very well. I checked on Metacritic, but most of the reviews are from unusual sources, not the big hitters. Big hitters haven't touched it. But it's a weird game. It's like it's hard to recommend completely because of that stuff in between. If people haven't got kids and stuff, it's like you're gonna have to kind of tread through a load of weird shit to get to the content.
I agree. I mean, this hasn't really been marketed at all, but I don't know whether the Disney connection is a blessing or a curse, because although there's this story where these characters are coming and going, hey, you're the apprentice, blah blah, there aren't any Disney tunes in it. There's the one song from the Sorcerer's Apprentice, and that's it. It's pop music. So why it's like Disney's Fantasia? I used to hate Fantasia when I was a kid. I was like, I love Disney, but like, get rid of that crap. That's boring. But so I don't know whether that's going to do them any favors. But I really hope people. I hope this finds people, because if it's aimed at anybody, it's kids, and primarily kids that like play stuff like Dance Central and Just Dance. This deserves to sell as well as one of those easily. I hope
it definitely
it does.
Deserves to find an audience.
Yeah,
I don't think it will do that, but it definitely does. And if you're like us, and there's plenty of people who are who love this genre and love, and if you love this genre, you love harmonics, then don't miss out. If you've got the gear, you know, if you've got the connect and the machine, make sure you pick it up at some point, because you just got to see, just to see what they've done. You know, it's so clever and weird and smart, and it works. I love harmonics. Quickly. Go and update Scout.